Hello, welcome to Let's Play of Factorio. I'm playing version 15.18. It's in beta. This is still an early access game. I funded the Indiegogo about 4 years ago, so I've been playing this game on and off for a long time. It's been a while since I've got to the end of this game, so they've added a lot of stuff at the end game that I haven't seen. So let's get started. I'm going to play a new multiplayer game, even though I'll mostly be playing single player. I like multiplayer because that way if you die, you just respawn instead of a game over screen where you have to reload. And it's the same kind of thing, but at least you just respawn. So I'll do a new game. I'm going to change some of the settings. The one setting I'm going to change is enemy expansion. I'm going to turn off. I don't really like enemy expansion just because it adds a lot of pressure because the enemies constantly build new bases closer to your base. And I'm constantly trying to chase down and destroy enemy bases that have freshly been created. Which just feels more frustrating than it's worth, usually. I'm going to leave on evolution, of course. That just means the monsters are going to get stronger. Leave on pollution. It means the monsters are kind of aggravated by the pollution I do. Recipe stuff is either normal or expensive. I'm going to leave it on normal. Technology is normal or expensive. Leave it on normal. I tried playing a game recently where both of these were on expensive. And it's kind of fun, but it's very slow. Just slows down the game a lot. And the other setting I'm going to change iron ore from size medium to size very big. Same thing with copper ore. That way I just don't have to chase down all these small patches. Coal and stone I don't really use too much. Uranium and coal is fine chasing those down because those are kind of late game things. The rest looks good, so let's generate this. And that looks good. Can plan land, not publicly. Alright, sounds good. Alright, let's take a look at the map. So we got some copper, coal, iron. There's our stone, there's our coal. Got 500,000 coal right there. A couple million. Iron ore and a couple million copper, which is really good. And some coal down here, which is good. So I might pull it from there first. We also need to pull off some stone. Let's go over this way and get our coal started. Coal is actually really easy to start in this game because you start with this thing, which can kind of self-feed. You can build an axe, build an iron axe. So you put some coal in there. And that will dump it into the furnace. So you can pull that out, put it in there. Alright, that's good for there. Grab some iron. And then walk back and smelt it. This game has a lot of Minecraft sensibilities to it, but it plays pretty different than Minecraft. It plays more like modded Minecraft if you've done that one, where there's lots of technology and it's a factory building game with some combat. But it's nothing similar to Command & Conquer. Command & Conquer is a very light factory game because you're placing workers that kind of just automatically build a simple base. This is more of assembly line management, which I quite enjoy. Alright, let's see. What is good to build first? need some stone. Early game's a bit slow. I'm sure there's ways to speedrun it, but I'm no expert at speedrunning this game. Thing I want to build is next as a driller now, so I don't have to manually pickaxe this stuff. While that's melting, I'll get some more stone. That and go pull it over here. Build one of these. Go cut down some wood. You don't need a lot of wood in this game. You usually get it just from deforesting things. Alright, that's good. And we can build a box. So that's working over there. Let's go back over here. Need that. I'll take this. Move this around. And then have it self-feed. You can take its output and put it back into the input, which is kind of neat. And the same thing for this. This will feed itself. These guys use coal to move. They don't use electricity. But they will actually drag coal to themselves if they need it. So this is fully self-sufficient. So this is just putting coal in a box now. Forever. So now we can just grab the excess coal as we come back. Alright, then down over here, we want to make sure that neither of these run out of coal until we hook up a more serious line going. I'm going to pull that out and build another one of couple more of these guys. Put their output in a box for now. It doesn't take too much to build electricity, so I'm going to build electricity pretty soon. And that's a lot easier than dealing with... dealing with these machines that need coal. Alright, so... let's go over to the copper. Let's actually pull this off and put it on the stone. That way, at least I have all the resources automatically being mined. Let's see, to build. Boiler. So I need some copper. So let's build a copper furnace over here. Get that going. There's my copper output. The steel or iron, I mean. So we have a steam engine now. Let's see. I need some more stone. The thing I'm missing is copper for. So now we have a boiler and a steam engine. I just need a water pump. There's an offshore pump. And now we're good to go. Build some electrical lines. Go over here to our water. Put that in the water. Boiler down. Oops, that's not the boiler, that's the steam engine. Put that. Let's see. Kind of want to move it away from the shore just a little bit. Build some pipes. And one more so I can eventually replace it with the underground version so I can get through. Have it going down like that, and now we need to feed coal to it, which is going to be the annoying part. I'm just holding click. All the way over here. Electricity's not going to work until I get coal over there to the broiler. I could manually move it, but I don't have a lot yet. Have 20. guess I should probably pick up these things and just work on generating coal. Because I want more of these. So I need one iron. Moving this out of the box. You can pick it up manually too. Manually walking this down to the broiler isn't going to be that efficient because it eats it pretty quick. Or at least it stops when it doesn't need it. Alright, so let's see. Build a couple of those. I should probably build a proper line. Let's see. Proper line is going to look like something like that. I can move it closer. Inserter, which uses electricity. Still need to power this by coal. So I need to manually put that in there. It looks like it has enough for that one. Let's go do the stone. So I don't have to deal with that. Yeah, that's working. Let's see, I need more iron. We'll build a second one of these. Do a box system for now until I get enough iron to move it manually. I mean, automatically on a conveyor belt. Switch this one to electric. Get a fast inserter, I'll just put two in. Might as well rig this one up. I'll keep these guys from getting stuffed, because these guys can only hold like, I think 100 or 50 or something like this in there. So I can just grab it from there. Might as well make some more, I guess. Always use more iron. Kind of what I'm waiting for anyways, iron production. Don't need much else at the moment. Because once I get enough iron, then I can make a bunch of transport belts. transport belts. Might have enough to get there. Looks like I'll do it. Don't need these anymore. Just empty the coal from a box here. Still need that guy. Put this coal back. I'll take a couple of the coals actually for the other machines I have far away. Until we can get enough to move all the coal over here. Down below, which might be closer. And there we go. So if I take it out, it starts feeding it. There we go. I guess I can start building coal production from down here now. Let's see. Two of those. Need more copper and wood, huh? Get some copper production going. Even if it's very limited right now. Bad thing is until I get the far reaching long handle things, it doesn't really matter. I can't automate this stuff anyway. I don't really want to go through the iron mine. I guess I can always move it. I'd just rather not. Just grab the iron from somewhere else. Alright. Let's There's the far-reaching one. I need to research this. I need to build a lab, which requires some copper. I need to increase my copper production. Stone. Put back the coal on this one. If you press Alt, then it'll show you icons of what's going on under the covers of each of these things. It's pretty useful to debug everything. Alright, there's some copper production. Let's route it to a box. Let's pick it up all manually. So I don't have a fast inserter yet. Alright. Now with some iron, I should be able to build a research station. Lab. Build a lab. And then build 10 of these science packs. This should allow me to research the automation, which allow me to get long-handled inserters, which allow me to put the coal in automatically. Oh, I just need to run electricity to these guys, huh? That. Producing enough iron. Let's build some more of those. These guys. Mining drills. Automation's finished, which is good. Let's see. This is a good one too. Need 20 of these science packs. Enough iron ore for now. Put some more science in. Just increase my production here just to fill out both sides. Looks like I'm getting low on electricity. Build another steam engine. Can 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 build these inserter arms, which will go here. Let's insert the coal so I don't go manually drag it. Which is nice. Cut a path straight up. This also give me a fast inserter. Okay, there we go. Those are all supplied with coal. I'm going to build just a simple stone furnace here, because eventually I might need stone. I won't bother fully automating it, just I'll just hook it up like that for now. Should be able to bring the copper down. Start automating some of this stuff. First thing I want to do is automate science packs. So I need gears. So I'm going to build a machine that automatically builds gears from iron. So that's a gear. I'll have it spit out on the one higher, but not this line. I'll have this line come up higher. Somewhere around there. Okay, we'll go like this. And then get some of these long dudes. Science packs with our copper. See, I want it right there. And gotta remove this box. Build another line right here. For the output. Start feeding the labs. Go. I just need more iron. Okay, Logistics is finished. Logistics, sorry. Don't want that. Steel's pretty good, I guess. It's fine. I'm gonna research them all eventually. Alright, well, now I can make fast inserters. And I'll do another fast inserter here. Just so I have some spots to grab iron and plates and copper plates, because those are pretty useful to build everything. I'm just going to keep expanding this so I can build more labs, more production. So it might be best to go up, maybe. Yeah, I might take the labs north. Have a whole row of labs that way. That one, this one. Okay. Making lots of red science potions. Copper. All right, steel's done. Let's grab some turret research. Research is done. Optics research. Thank you. Antarctic research is done. Stonewall research. Build some more conveyors, electric poles. Okay, that little thing is doing good. This is doing fine. Stonewall research is done. Military research. Research is done. Electronic research. Flying through the researchers now. I think I need to expand my steel production. It's not very big. Let's make a bunch of those. I think I want to lay my furnaces out this direction, I guess. Actually, north is best, so I don't know. Yeah, I guess continuing north is fine. Because everything's lined up that way. I also have to move the copper. Electronics is done. Heavy armor. Guess I can run this one other direction. Any of the long ones. have ore pretty soon, so let's work on that. Oops, not that one. That's okay, I have a splitter. Didn't want a splitter, that's okay. Into itself. Heavy armor's done. Automation 2. All right. Yes, when I put that, see now it's only filling up the left-hand side. And that means this one's only filling up the right-hand side, so that way there'll be more used both lines. I think that's enough iron production for a while. I need more electricity. Let's go grab some copper and some iron. Thank you. more copper. Let's see, I need a broiler and some stone. Two steam engines. And probably some pipe. Take one of these underground pipes. Mission 2 is done. Bullet damage. Let's research the assault rifle. Some guns, some light armor. Couple turrets. It over there, hit tab to switch weapons. I'm using an assault rifle. That's probably a good time to build a radar. Let's build 4 radars. Put one in the corner, each corner of our base. So we can start to see what's out there. Takes a while to get attacked on normal. It's not too hard. Those radars will start to expand the map so we can see more of this black area. Because the map is actually pretty big. It's crazy. Alright, got lots of ore generation. Pretty good on steel. Maybe I should move my box to over here. Pull from right there. So grab some both lines. put some more ore, coal generation over here. Just on this side. Just to flush up both sides. I'm pretty full up on potions. I need to build some more labs. Let's see, before I do that, let's go build some transport belts. Bullet damage is done. I don't think there's anything else more useful. Yeah, everything else is needs green. I don't really care about fluids right now. Should be good. Okay, how do I build green? Inserters and transport belts. Transport belts are gears and iron plates. Gears and iron plates right there. And some more iron. Space them out a little bit in case I want to build more gears. So I have to move everything. There's an achievement that to win the game without building anything out of like 110 items. That's pretty impressive. How do you possibly do that? I'll have to watch a YouTube video about how someone does this. It's like 110 items by hand. Like everything else is automated. It's like super ridiculous. Let's see, where is it? It's in one of these. Maybe it's a secret achievement. Oh, there it is, sorry. Lazy bastard. Win the game by crafting no more than 111 items manually. That's impressive. Because I'm constantly building items. Put these labs down while those inserters finish. Never have enough inserters. Should be enough, you think? I don't know. We'll start with 4 for now. These are pretty sweet to store up too, because transport belts are super useful. So I like having a box of these. As part of the green, and then an inserter. So electric circuit, gear, and an iron plate. There's the gear and the iron plate. I need electric circuit. Electric circuit is iron plate and copper cable. I haven't made copper cable yet. Far away, because I have a feeling I'm going to need a bunch of it. I think this is one of these vicious ones where it takes a lot of copper. Stop the episode and I'll be right back.